What are you sitting in front of there?
This tractor was purchased by my Uncle Alvin, and the date on the bill of sale, which I've got right here, January 15th, 1952. It was delivered in 1952, but it's a 1951 serial number. So I have the bill of sale, which is total purchase price is $2,420. He got $1,150 trade-in on his WC tractor, which was an older tractor. And this tractor cost him a total of $2,110, which is a pretty good price. I remember when this tractor was delivered, brand new off the truck from the dealership. The dealer was Geneva Farm Equipment, and that's what it says on the bill of sale. Also on the tractor, there's a tag, a dealer tag, Geneva Farm Equipment on Bennett Street in Geneva, Illinois, where the tractor was delivered from new. This tractor, when I backed it off the truck, was brand new. It had never been driven before by anybody other than loading the tractors. I remember smelling the burnt paint off the exhaust manifold when I'd started up in the shed where we stored it. I spent probably 2 years of my life pretty much on the farm with this tractor at home there before I left and went to work on my own. And it was kept and used by my cousin and my uncle in the operation in Batavia. And I was lucky enough to be able to get it before it was salvaged. And I restored it completely from all new seals and bearings and rings and, well, everything. It's been repainted. It looks better than a new tractor right now. It's got a better shine because we know how to paint now with clear coats. So it will never probably ever do a lick's work again other than chase around the fields, maybe pulling a wagon with some people on it, or just taking me out to look at the crops, one or the other.
What was it used for primarily on the farm?
Well, it was used for everything. We pulled a picker with it. We pulled a chopper, one row chopper. We had a one row picker. We had a baler, a round baler that Allis Chalmers made. We had one of those. We had rakes, partake of rake that was made by Allis. We had a 7-foot pull type mower for cutting hay. It was used. We had one other tractor. We had a smaller tractor, an Allis Chalmers C that would use for hauling manure and other light jobs. But if there was something to be done, this tractor did it. And I have no idea how many thousands of hours is on it, but it's been rode hard and sometimes probably put away wet, because after I left the farm at home there, I didn't really keep track of what it was doing because I was not involved. So it's a delight to have. I'll never sell it. I'd instruct my kids not to sell it, even if they got to build a house to put it in. So that's up to them.
Well, now it's in video. Who all do you think drove it after you left? Or while you were there, did your mom ever drive it?
My sister Marge drove it. We've got some pictures with her driving it on a baler. And Bob, my cousin Bob, was my sister's age. He was 8 years younger than I am, or 6 years younger. So he and Alvin was his father, my uncle. My sisters drove it. My brother drove it a little bit because he was not involved with stuff at home very much. He went and left home quick. But I remember one time I had a 41 Plymouth. Talk about the crazy stuff. Ronnie Shanklin and I were out one night and there's a railroad track running into Batavia from the east along Wilson Street. And we had the crazy idea that we could get on that railroad track a little ways out in the country and we could drive it right into town on the tracks with the cars. Well, it lined up perfectly. The only thing that we didn't do that we should have done is let some more air out of the tires because they didn't want to ride on the rails very long. Promptly fell off the rails. We were back in probably quarter mile, half mile maybe, from the crossing where we got on. So I had to walk home. It was probably a couple of miles to the farm, get this tractor, back it down the tracks with a chain and hook onto my car, drag the car up on the railroad tracks backwards until we got back to the crossing where we got on the tracks to start with. And that's one experience that the tractors had that I'm not too proud of, but shows how dumb kids can be.
Fortunately, no trains were coming that time of day.
No, that was a one train a day track, so.
And where was that?
Right through Batavia. There's a convenience store there now where it crosses and goes into town from the east.
So this tractor has never seen a day of work on this farm?
No.
Where you worked?
No, it was hauled in here, it wouldn't run. It was pulled on the trailer with a winch. And it had set outside, so there was water in the cylinders, and the cylinders were rusted, fastened to the sidewall cylinders. The pistons and the cylinders were locked. When I took it apart, I had to use a sledgehammer and a 2x4 to get the pistons out of the cylinders, they were so bad. The total reconstruction of the head, all new valves, valve guides, valve seats, valve springs, of course bearings and rings. We use wet cylinders, so you replace the cylinder with the piston and everything in it. So that was not a hard part to do, but it was just doing it right.
And when was it brought here again?
Well, he quit milking and he was in his 80s when he was in his 90s when he died. But he had probably quit milking 20 years before that, maybe. So I would guess 70, maybe, late 60s, maybe.
So it has obviously all new tires. The rims are the same, but you just painted them. Same engine, same housing and everything. What new parts are on it?
Well, the rims are original. It had calcium chloride in the tires for weight, additional weight for traction. So they were notorious for leaking out of the where you fill it, you know. And calcium chloride leaking on metal would eat the metal. So these rims were in bad shape where the valve stems came through the rims to put air in the tires. So I had Bill Hannon take an old rim that I had, cut a piece out of the existing rim and weld a new piece in that was good. So now you look at the rims, they look like they've never been rusted, but they were in tough shape. The engine, of course, was basically sound, just the moving parts, cylinders, rings, stuff like that had to be replaced. It took it was in a building that had stuff fall down on it, so the hood was bent, muffler was bent. I had to get a new muffler, and we fought the hood for quite a while to make it fit. And it fits decent, not perfect, but it fits good. I had to put new brakes on it because they were worn out totally. One thing I did do wrong, I think, maybe, it's got a noise in second gear. And I wasn't aware of that until I had finished building it. When I had it apart, I took the transmission covers off and turned it through all the gears, I thought. So I checked to see if there was any teeth missing or any obvious bearing wear. And I didn't see anything, but I still got a noise in second gear. Second gear is the gear that we use for most of the heavy-duty work, plowing and disking. But I can run it in first, third, and fourth, and it doesn't make any noise, so I don't think it's going to bother, because I'll never hook a plow to it anymore.
Has this ever made it to Moose's plow days?
No.
Okay.
It never will.
So you primarily take the Ferguson?
Ferguson, the M. WD-45, the other WD. This one is just for looks. I take it to the fair, a couple of fairs.
So this one's got a warm spot in your heart?
I would say, yeah. I've also got another uncle's tractor, the B, that's in the shop now. It's not totally done, but it's getting close. It's got a warm spot in my heart because my Uncle Morris up in northern Wisconsin bought the tractor in 1948, and then he bought it new. As kids, we would go up there every summer, spend a month or 3-4 weeks. That's where my dad is from.
And where in Michigan?
Marinette, Wisconsin.
Wisconsin.
McAllister, Wisconsin. And my cousin Gene and I would sit. The B has got a wide seat, so he can set two people on it comfortably without falling off. So I spent a lot of time on the seat of that tractor, too. But it's going to be pretty, too. It's all... Everything is painted except some minor stuff, and it's a little bit more alignment and adjustment to put things back together. But I should be out working on it now. The tractors behind me, the little 110 John Deere's, are one of them's a copy of the one we used to have out here that we used in the cow yard. We had a little dozer blade, and we had tire chains and weights on it. And we wore it out doing that, and I found another one that was real nice. I had an attachment to make a power takeoff for it, to run the elevators and stuff, and I restored that so it's on edge. You can see how that went.
I didn't realize the earlier one of those we actually used to push manure around the cow lot.
Yep. I didn't keep them. I probably wore the blade out. And I wore the tractor out because that was practically junk when we got rid of it. Meridian had this one on, stored away in the back. And I bought it because it was so nice. I painted the wheels, and that's all I've done to it.